Hello friends, welcome to Testing Dunya, and today we will see waterfall model. It is a type of SDLC model, software development lifecycle model. We have already seen SDLC, what is SDLC in previous video, and in this video we see one type of SDLC model that is known as waterfall model. So what is waterfall model? We will see in this video. Let's start. What is waterfall model? Waterfall model is very first model that is used in software development. It is also known as a linear sequential model because it goes linearly. It progresses linearly from one stage to other stage. Second point, in this model, the outcome of one phase acts as input for the next phase. Waterfall model is divided into different phases or stages. So the input of one stage is work as output of one stage will work as an input for other stage. Development of the next phase starts only when the previous phase is complete. We cannot skip one phase and go to the other until the previous phase has been completed. So it is a linear model. You cannot skip a particular stage and or you can go back to the previous stage once you complete that. This is a pictorial representation of waterfall model. It is divided into different stages. Like first is requirement analysis. In this, requirement is analyzed by the team and to gather all the requirements from customer or client. This phase is requirement analysis. After requirement analysis phase, the design phase will start. And all the inputs of requirement analysis acts as a all the output of requirement analysis phase acts as a input for design phase. In design phase, all the relative design being developed by the relevant team. After design completion, the coding or development phase start where software developers write the code for each functionality and module. After completion of coding, then testing phase is start, and after doing successful testing and bug fixation, the product goes to the deployment phase where that your application or your software is deployed in production. After deployment in production, your application or project will be in maintenance phase for further enhancement or bug fixation of production or some modification or improvements. So these are different phases. In waterfall model, each part of SDLC is divided as a stage, and each is defined as a different category or different activity. And the main point is that coding phase will not start before design, and testing will not start before coding is complete. So it is a linear sequential model. You cannot jump to a particular stage without completing the previous stage. So this is the waterfall model basic, like it is a falling water from a top to bottom. Now we'll see advantages of waterfall model. It is a simple and easy to use and understand. This model is very simple to implement and easy to use because each activity is divided into a phase, and after completion of that phase, we will move further to the next phase. It is easy to manage, no complexity. Works well in smaller projects having low budget and clear requirement. In the projects where our requirements are pretty clear and our project is less complex and it is a low budgeted project, then waterfall model is very feasible in that conditions. In waterfall model, each stage is clearly defined and well understood. So what are the, now we'll see what are the disadvantages of waterfall model. First one, no working software until the end of project life cycle. From starting means from analysis to that development and testing before deployment, you are not getting any working software in your hands. So there might be some curiosity and some suspension about the working product, what will be the final product. So it is a main disadvantage. Not feasible for large and complex project. If your project is very large and complex, you cannot wait till the end to see the end product, and high amounts of risk and uncertainty involved. There is a huge risk in waterfall model and uncertainty, because if you miss something in design phase and it will come up to you in deployment phase, then it is very very difficult to traverse back to the design phase and make all changes. Then after, you need to modify your code and then test again. It will be very highly cost, and it impact your project very badly. The last disadvantage is it cannot accommodate changing requirement. So if in the middle of the project you want to change some requirement as a client, but it is very difficult to accommodate these changes in waterfall model methodology. So these are the very basic and the very obvious disadvantages of waterfall model. So this waterfall model is a very important concept for software engineering, and I hope you get the idea of waterfall model. If you like this video, please like, and if you want to get more updates and all notifications, please subscribe my channel. Thank you.